What's up, YouTube, man? You know, I'm back, man, with these patch 6 notes for you, man. I know I just now got the update. I know a lot of you guys already got the update. So if you already got the update, I'm pretty sure you kind of have a feel of maybe what has been changed. If you've been getting lagged out, been getting loaded in with the wrong player build and all that. But I'm going to get into the little notes. Now, I don't know if these are not the official notes, but these notes cover what was patched in this patch 6. So fixed neighborhood invite issues. I'm actually reading off my phone. So fixed neighborhood invite issues. So of course, when people invite you to the neighborhood, you will never go in their neighborhood, even if it was like 80 people out of 150 people that can be on the server, or even if it's like 70 people out of 90 or 80 or 100 people to be on the server, you will never load into the playground, which they should have fixed that. They should have fixed that from the jump. Also, it says fixing issue related to loading in with the wrong build. Now, I know everybody that I play with on this game, we all have that issue. Like, we can never join each other. We try to join through the party. We try to join through the phone. Every time we join, it'll always load us. Every time I join, it would load me in on my big man. Like, we'd be running wreck. We'd need another guard. We already got 2 centers. I try to load in on somebody, man. We got 3 centers. You know, if you don't go in the rec with a full squad and you got 3 centers or 2 centers in the power 4, it's gonna be a minute before you get a game, if you even get a game. So that's fixed. I know I encountered that issue for about 2 weeks, and I think it just recently started, like maybe about a couple days. Recently stopped like a couple days ago, to where I can load in on my offensive threat. You know what I'm saying? And also added networking connection fixes. I know a lot of people was talking about getting blue screened a lot, which I, at the beginning of the game, when the game first came out, I was getting a lot of blue screens. Since then, I really haven't gotten nothing but like 1 blue screen since like the first week and a half of the game. So I didn't really experience that too much. Like a lot of other people that I know experienced that. But the next one is fixed blue screen errors on PS4. Okay. That's touching bases on what I just said about the blue screens. But the adding the network connection fixes, that is touching bases on like Pro-Am. Have you ever been, not Pro-Am, but I'm talking about rec. So people in Pro-Am may experience it too. I don't really play Pro-Am. But have you ever been in a rec game, and then after the rec game, once the rec game ends, it kicks you all the way to the main menu, the main loading screen with Anthony Davis, and it says network connection failure or something like that. So that covers that. Now, the next one is fixed crashing issues. Now, I mean, you would think that network fix, connection fixes and blue screen errors was basically it, but I guess it wasn't. It fixed whatever crashing issues there was with the game. I know a lot of people have been having issues, but here's the thing that I understand. A lot of people may have shitty internet also, which may cause their shit to crash. You know what I'm saying? So I know I've experienced that to when my internet was when I first started gaming. We had AT&T or something like that. We didn't have that much on it, but we had Netflix tied to it, and then we had like 5 different tablets, 2 different game systems tied to it. And every time I would go in and play the game or even try to stream, it would just shut my whole shit down. You know what I'm saying? And that wasn't due to the game itself. It was due to my internet connection. We had a shitty internet connection. So a lot of you guys may need to update your internet connection. I know a lot of you cats is young. I know a lot of you cats live with your mama and stuff like that. But for the most part, you know, you need to update your internet connection. Tell your mama, let you get the LAN, let you get the Ethernet. You know what I'm saying? Tell your mama, let you get the Ethernet cord and stuff like that. So, and the next one is added performance and stability improvement. So hopefully that little park lag, because I did experience that. I hadn't experienced that this year, which is shitty. I did experience that park frames dropping or something. Even spike lag with the jump shot. Now, when they say added performance and stability improvements, I hope they fix that, because there's been multiple times to where you try to go up for a jump shot and it's glitching and it's lagging, or it's spike lagging and all that stuff, to where you got a glitchy bar. So hopefully they fix that. Also, the next thing it says underneath these notes is address stuttering and lag issues. I don't know what the stuttering and the lag issues was about. I guess it could be The game just randomly lagging at times and stuff like that. I guess that's what they mean by the stuttering and lag issues, stuff like that. The game just randomly lagging at times. But like I said, I'm not completely sure, but that's what I'm thinking it is, because like, I didn't really have any stuttering in gameplay or any lag issues, really. So, and the last that I see on this list is various other minor fixes added. So we don't know what that means, but these patch notes came from NBA 2K Intel at NBA 2K Intel, which is the Twitter name. Patch notes for patch six. So I mean, but I know a lot of people have been talking about. This little demigod thing. I wanted to touch on this. A lot of people talking about the little demigod glitch or whatever it is, or somebody running around with a 70 overall big man who can dribble or stuff like that, who got shooting badges and all that stuff. I don't know the exact detail, but hopefully they put that in there to kind of patch that up. So, you know, people always looking for a way to get over on the game. People's always looking for a way to cheat the game and stuff like that. So hopefully they put that, hopefully they got that and, you know, got that all the way together and stuff. So, but there you go, man. As we know it, there's the patch six notes now. The official notes, I mean, have really not been released. But as far as these notes that I've read, I can almost be positive that this is probably what they actually did do. And this is the only thing they probably did do in this patch, you know. So, because if they didn't, it'd be other things. But Here's one thing that I'm glad they did not do. I'm glad they didn't touch the gameplay. See, typically when they drop these patches, they want to patch this badge, they want to patch this build, they want to nerf this jump shot, they want to nerf that build, they want to do all this extra stuff besides what they actually did. So I'm glad that they didn't nerf this base, nerf this jump shot, nerf this shooting. But once again, and we've been having a whole lot of hot fixes. I had a hot fix earlier today, and hot fixes is whenever you have to go to the main menu, whenever you get that a little error thing or a little message in the bottom left hand corner of your screen that says go to the main menu, blah 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 blah. When they do that, they're hot fixing and patching stuff up. You know what I'm saying? So we don't. What I would like to know, me personally, I would like to know what goes on. What are they patching? What are they fixing? What are they reducing? What are they buffing? You know, what badges are they nerfing? Because they're doing a lot of different type of things to the game that we're really not knowing, we don't know about. Only thing we ever get really the notes about, honestly, is the patch notes. Or if we question Mike Wang or who or LD2K about what was the update about, they may be like the update. Excuse me, my phone ringing. They may be like that update was fixing this, was fixing that. So I would like to see a lot more information on the little regular schedule updates. I don't know if it's just regularly maintenance, you know what I'm saying, maintenance towards the game or whatever it may be, but I like to see a lot more patch notes, information on that. But as far as patch six, like I said, the game just now finished downloading as I'm recording it. I'm literally sitting beside the screen. I seen it said added to your download, so it's completely installed. So what I'm about to do, I'm about to get off here. I'm about to load in with my players, and I'm about to test this stuff. I'm about to see if I can send somebody an invite, and on the first time. When I send that, they click on the invite on the first time if they come to my park. I'm going to see that. Not on the second time, not on the third or fourth, fifth time, but on the first time. Because if I send somebody I'm running with an invite, and on the first time, if they can't come to my park, then they didn't do their job with the patch. You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to test that out. I'm also going to be trying to join different people to see if I load in on the build that I want to play with. I don't want to load in on my big man. I don't want to load in on this. I don't want to load in on it. I want it to work the first time I try to do it. You know what I'm saying? So, but there you have it. Like always, sub up if you ain't subbed up. Man, turn them notifications on. You know, make sure to click that bell. Make sure you click the bell, man. You know, turn notice on. Click the bell. That's how you turn notice on. You click the bell. And like I said, share this video with, you know what I'm saying, whoever's interested in knowing why they had to download NBA 2K 1.6 patch.